Hello, everyone, and welcome back for a special review on this day on Juneteenth, 2020. I decided to do a review of a movie that I feel helps highlight some of the great and hidden people who have helped and people who have contributed to not only African American history, Black history, but to American history as well. And so I decided to dip back a couple of years to 2016 with Hidden Figures. It is based on the nonfiction book Hidden Figures by Margot Lee Shetterly. Hidden Figures tells the story of three women working at NASA. Each of them are pretty much geniuses, mathematical geniuses, human computers, calculators, as they were known back then. It stars Taraji P. Henson as Katherine Johnson, or Katherine Goebel, as she was known previously, before she got remarried. It stars excuse me, Octavia Spencer as Dorothy Vaughn, Janelle Monáe as Mary Jackson, and it also features a wide variety and a assorted cast. It also has Kevin Costner, Kristen Dunst, or Kirsten Dunst, I always mispronounce her name, Jim Parsons, Mahershala Ali, Glenn Powell, Aldis Hodge, whole bunch of people in this movie, whole lot of talented actors. Hans Zimmer and Pharrell were doing the music for the movie. This movie, it really is a feel-good movie for me. There is a lot of American history and contributions by minorities and Black people that often don't get talked about. And this is something that I had no idea. Whenever you think of the space race, whenever you hear anything related to it, especially when I was growing up, we didn't get stories about these types of people. There's so many things that we've contributed, that Black people have contributed to society, to science, to pretty much everything. And those stories still aren't known. And so the book Hidden Figures, as well as this film, it does a great and a necessary job of highlighting that. It tells the story of the space race between the United States and the Soviet Union, the trials and tribulations that the US had to go through with getting a man into orbit, with making sure that the landing capsules work, because get somebody up in space, you gotta find a way to get them back down, and how key each one of these women were in their capacity. Dorothy Vaughn, the one who was played by Octavia Spencer, she was a supervisor and a mathematician. She acts as sort of the boss figure a little bit towards the other women, especially of the Black women. She figures out how to get the IBM computer that they need for the calculations. She figured out how to get that functioning and working properly. Mary Jackson, the engineer, helped with making sure that the landing capsule worked properly so that it didn't reheat and turn into a fireball upon reentry. And Katherine Johnson is noted. She's one of the, excuse me, a mathematician, helping with the calculations and getting the precise measurement for the orbit, for the landing. And it is all high level, high intelligence stuff that I wouldn't even begin to know how to decipher. Because this movie is set in the past, it's set in the 1960s, you get the racism and you get overt racism, like the situation in the library that Dorothy and her sons find, as well as the whole seeing colored water fountains. And you also get the more subtle racism, particularly by Kirsten Dunst's character, Vivian Mitchell. She's the head supervisor, so she's over Dorothy Vaughn. And her type of racism is one that I think is encountered a lot more often and is the one that's hardest to tell, because there's subtle things that people say, there's subtle movements that people make. And Vivian's character, Kirsten's character, she was not. There were moments where I'm like, where I give Kirsten the little side eye a little bit. Jim Parsons from The Big Bang Theory, he plays an engineer. The head engineer of the Space Task Group in NASA. And he's got that subtle racism shit going too. In fact, a lot and we see this a lot in the movie. Kevin Costner, his character Al Harrison, he's the director, and he doesn't really have that subtle racism. He's one of the good white dudes, and it's something that I kind of don't really like in movies like this, especially ones that are based on a true story. Too often, a lot of movies that revolve around Black history have sort of a white savior figure, and that's some white person who magically appears to help the Black people. And look, there are plenty of actual historical real life white people who helped during the civil rights movement, who helped in getting Black people in positions of power. There's plenty of examples of that. You kind of don't need to make them up. And Al Harrison in this movie, he's a made-up white person. And it's just like, you could have used someone else. In fact, the biggest criticism of the movie is that there are some historical inaccurate. There are about 25% of the movie, from what some research has been done about it. It's 25% roughly of it is inaccurate, with it being about 75% accurate. And so a good portion of it is true, but they did take some creative liberties. For example, some of the characters, like Dorothy, like Catherine, they actually didn't face the discrimination in the years. Going back and looking where Dorothy about Dorothy, she had already been promoted and made a supervisor well before the 1961 situation. Catherine, in the movie, one of the big kind of like dramatic moments in the movie is that she had to go about half a mile to the colored part of NASA in the West Computer buildings to use the restroom, and Kevin Costner eventually chops down the colored sign, or the whites only sign, for them to use the bathroom. And it's a great moment symbolically, but turns out that Catherine actually had to use the white restrooms for years with no one kind of before anyone complained, because she logically said, yeah, I'm not rushing and going all the way on the other side of the campus just to use the restroom. And so it would take her about 45 minutes, and then it was a really big dramatic moment. And so there's also the fact that Mary, she didn't have to get a court order to attend night classes in order to become an engineer. And so there are some liberties that were taken, and I would highly recommend actually doing some separate research and looking into the lives of these women, because they are incredible. Each of these women, they've been honored. Katherine Johnson received the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Both Dorothy Vaughan and Mary Jackson, they've also been honored by Congress. Dorothy Vaughan actually has a crater on the moon named after her, and a school in Utah a couple of years ago changed the name of a school. It was Jackson in honor of President Andrew Jackson, but because he's kind of a terrible piece of shit, they renamed it in honor of Mary Jackson. And so the lives of these women, they do need to be told, they do need to be remembered, and they do need to be highlighted for what they contributed and for how important they are. And I think doing some separate research, actually reading the Hidden Figures book, I think that would be a great place to start in looking them up, because truth is always a little bit better than the fiction that's portrayed. And I'll say this: the movie itself, it's well made, it's feel good, it tugs at your heartstrings. There's a lot of good moments in this movie that are actually accurate. John Glenn not wanting to go into space unless Catherine specifically reviewed the calculations. In real life, it took, a couple of days for her to figure out the calculations instead of a few minutes, because that would be stupid to delay a launch and only give a person a couple of minutes or maybe a few hours to redo the calculations, instead of giving them a few days, because you're sending someone into space. And so while that moment, it did happen in real life, and it is significant that he specifically wanted Catherine to review the numbers that were calculated by the computers, it is a little, they did take some liberties with it. And yeah, I think overall this movie, it's a nice feel-good movie. It highlights people who we absolutely need to recognize continuously. And for this Juneteenth, I thought it was great not to watch something depressing, not to watch something, not to watch a downer or anything, just something good, something wholesome, something enjoyable that can highlight the importance of these women and what they did. And so, yeah, I would recommend it. I think it's a good movie, especially for kids to watch. It could spark a little interest in them wanting to explore space. Who knows what it could, what it could inspire in people. But yeah, this movie is excellent, and I recommend it. Is it the most historically accurate? No, there's some things that need to be that weren't correct, but I do think it does its job in giving the shine to these women. So go ahead, take your time and watch it. I believe this is on Disney Plus if you have that streaming service. It's not an expensive movie to purchase digitally either. So take your time, take this day and go watch this movie, along with all the other art, all the other contributions that African Americans, that Black folk have made to the world. Go ahead and enjoy some of that on this Juneteenth. That's it for the review. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Make sure to celebrate, enjoy, do it responsibly because we still got a pandemic going on. And as always, take care of yourself. Don't be an asshole to people. And I will catch you guys next time. Peace.